Are you tired of QR code generators that ask you to pay just to download your own design? What if I told you that you can make QR codes completely free and fully functional right inside Canva? I'll walk you through exactly how to do it step by step. No extra software, no subscriptions, no catches. Hi, my name is Jennifer Maker, and I've been teaching smart design shortcuts for years. And this trick is one of my favorites. And just for fun, I'll show you how I use Canva's QR code maker to create a luggage tag that links to a lost and found form so you can see just how versatile this can be. And don't worry, if you're not familiar with QR codes or online forms, they're both super easy to create with the help of some handy Canva apps. So if you're ready to stop paying for something you can make for free, let's jump in. But first, what is a QR code? It's short for Quick Response Code, and it's a scannable square that can instantly link to just about anything. A website, a form, a PDF, a video, a social media page, whatever you need. They're like magic shortcuts people can open with their phones. No typing required. And when you know how to make your own, you can use them on business cards, labels, packaging, signs, tags, really anywhere. So let me show you how easy it is by making a luggage tag with a QR code. Let's start by downloading my free luggage tag design files. Head to jennifermaker.com/754 and access the free library. Click Get a Password if you need one or enter the library. Then search for design number 754 and click the download link. This folder contains three high-quality PNG designs featuring a sunny Hawaiian beach, a peaceful lake scene, and a vibrant New York City skyline. There's also a handy outline template to help you align your design perfectly in Canva. If you're unsure how to upload these files, visit jennifermaker.com/svgs for a quick and easy tutorial. Next, place your luggage tag blank with the hole at the top in front of you. Measure the tag's width and height. Jot those numbers down. You'll need them in Canva to size your design just right. Now it's time to head to Canva. In your computer browser, go to jennifermaker.com/canva. Log in or create a free account if you don't already have one. If this is your first time using Canva and you'd like to learn the basics before getting started, check out my Canva Coach Playbook. It has tons of helpful information and teaches you how to use all of Canva's most popular features. On the Canva homepage, click Create. Then click Custom Size to set your canvas dimensions. Click the Units drop-down and select IN for inches. Now add a quarter inch to your tag's width measurement and type that number in the Width Value field. Add a quarter inch to the height as well. The extra space creates a bleed area around your design, which helps prevent those unwanted white edges where the ink might not fully reach. Click Create New Design to open your blank canvas. Then click the File Name area and type in a new name for your design. To upload my outline template, click the Uploads button, then Upload Files. Find my PNG design folder. Then select the template file and click Open, or double-click it to upload it. Click the uploaded template to place it on your canvas. To resize the template to match your luggage tag's measured dimensions, select the template and then click Position. Under the Position panel's Advanced section, make sure the ratio lock is closed, then enter your luggage tag's width measurement. Then, under the Align to Page section, click Center and Middle to center the luggage tag outline on your canvas. Next, click the icon above your canvas that looks like two rectangles to duplicate the page. Scroll back to page 1 to work on your first side's design. Upload the design you want to use, like one of my downloads. Or design your own customized luggage tag using a special toolkit that's only available in my Advance with Jennifer Maker program. I even have an exclusive design workshop where I show you how to create a personalized suitcase tag that shows off your unique travel style by making any image look like a sticker. Plus, there's a Canva frame template just for members to make designing even easier. To learn more about this workshop and other members-only resources, head over to jennifermaker.com/advance. Click the image to add it to your canvas. If you're using the Hawaii design, rotate the image by dragging the rotate handle until it fits the tag vertically. Next, resize the image to completely fill the canvas. Then click position and select to back under the arrange options to move the image behind the tag outline template. Make sure no important elements are located in the tag's hole. That area won't transfer during sublimation. Select the outlines template on this page and click the trash can icon to delete it. And now side one is ready. To create the side two of your luggage tag with your QR code, scroll down to page two. Click text from the side panel, then add a text box. Double-click inside the box to type a fun or meaningful message. To change your typeface, select the text box and click the font name at the top. On the left, the font menu will appear. Click the filter icon, check the free box, then click apply to only show options you can use without purchasing. Then select one you like. Use the text box's side handles to adjust line length and the corner handles to make your text larger or smaller as needed. To change the color of your text, click the toolbar button with the letter A above a color box and choose a new option. I'll keep mine black. Then move your text box where you like. Just avoid placing it where the tag's hole will go. If you like, add a second text box with instructions for someone who finds your bag. A quick way to do this is to click the duplicate button just above the first text box, then edit the text and settings. Your luggage tag layout is ready to go and just needs one final touch, the QR code. But before we create it, we need to set up something important, a place for that QR code to lead to. This could be a simple contact page or form, something someone can view or fill out if your tag is found and scanned. Let's create that first, and then we'll come back to generate the code and add it to your tag. First, click on the apps icon. Type Jotform in the search bar and select it from the results, then click open. Your panel might look a little different if you've used Jotform already, but you can still use these directions as a guide. Click Start for Free in the Jotform panel. Then click Connect to connect Jotform with your Canva account. In the Sign Up Now pop-up window, choose a method to create your account. I like using Google because it's fast and easy. Check the box to agree to Jotform's terms and policies, then click Continue. Click Allow to give the apps permission to share data. Back in Canva, you should see a section titled Your Forms inside the Jotform panel. Click Create New Form. You'll get a message saying you're leaving Canva. That's okay. Click Continue and Jotform will open in a new browser tab with a blank form ready to go. Be sure to leave Canva open in your original tab so you can quickly return to it later. On the Organization Settings screen, click the X if you do not wish to upload an organization logo or set an organization name. You can customize the form's text, like clicking Form to edit the title. For the subtitle, write something friendly and clear to encourage the person who found your bag to get in touch. Next, we'll add a few form fields to collect information. On the left, you'll see the Form Elements panel. Click the big plus sign beside Add Form Element. Click the Address element, and some labeled fields will drop into your form. Once it's in place, click on the address field to edit the label and add simple instructions for the person who finds your bag. Select and adjust any other field titles you would like to customize to gather the information you need. Next, add the full name field to your form and adjust it so the finder knows to leave the name of the person your bag was turned over to. Now let's add a date picker element and adjust it to allow the bag finder to note when they found your bag. If you want the information to be required, click on a field, then click the gear icon to open its properties panel. Under the General tab, toggle Required to On. I recommend doing this for both the address and date found fields. You can also customize the individual subfields inside a section, like removing the zip code since someone might not know that if they're also traveling. You can customize the Submit button in its properties menu too. I'll change mine to say Submit Report. To personalize the form's appearance, click the paint roller icon in the top right corner to open the form designer. You can change colors, typefaces, and more if you like. When you're finished, click the Preview Form toggle at the top to see how it will look on phones, tablets, and desktops. If you notice a mistake, now's a good time to go back and fix it. Next, click the Settings tab at the top and make sure the form status is set to Enabled, so your form is live and ready to collect responses. Then click the Emails tab on the left. Check that the Notification 1 item lists the email address where you want to receive completed forms. If this tab is blank or incorrect, check out the detailed instructions on our blog to fix it. Finally, click the Publish tab. Click the Copy Link button to grab the shareable link to your form. Next, return to page 2 of your Canva design. Click on the Apps icon again. In the search bar, type QR code. Click the QR code app with a plain black and white icon. It should say Created by Canva when you hover over the 3 dots. Click Open, then paste your form link into the URL box. Next, click the Customize drop-down arrow and change the colors to match your tag's theme. I'll select the foreground swatch and change it to teal to match my bottom text. Then click Generate Code to insert the QR code on your canvas. Resize and position the QR code on your luggage tag as desired. Next, let's add a visual element to highlight the QR code. Go to Elements in the side panel to open Canva's Media Library. You can use the search bar if you're looking for something specific, like an arrow. Scroll through and find an image you like, then click to add it. Sometimes a graphic is the same color as your canvas, so all you see is the border. Simply click the color swatch, this one looks like a rainbow, and pick a different color. Use the element's corner handles to resize it as needed. Then drag the curved arrows outside the bounding box to rotate it and position the element as desired. I'll have mine point from the bottom text to my QR code so the bag finder knows just what to do. Next, let's add a helpful trimming guide so you can cut out your design more accurately after it's printed. Click Elements, then scroll down to Shapes and click the simple square. Select the square, then click the Stroke Style icon. It looks like 3 horizontal lines. Set the stroke type to a solid line and adjust the weight to 1 point. Resize the square by dragging the handles until it completely fills the canvas. With the square selected, click the solid color swatch. Then select the option with the red slash to apply no color to the inside of the shape. Now you have a thin black border right at the canvas's edges. Click the position button and select to back under the arrange section to move our new trimming guide to the bottom. Then select the template PNG and click the trash can icon to remove the outlines. And now page 2 is complete. To save your design to your computer, click the share button in the upper right corner of your Canva window. Then choose download. Make sure the file type is set to PNG to preserve the image quality for beautiful prints. Under Select Pages, choose pages 1 and 2 to include both sides of your tag. Then click the Download button to save your design as a zip file. Locate your downloaded file and unzip it so you can easily grab both images. And now your luggage tag designs are ready to print and press. If you need help sublimating your luggage tag, you can follow the printing and sublimating instructions from my Make Your Own Magnets tutorial. When uploading your designs to Google Docs, make sure to change the width of your images to 2.65 inches so you have a bleed area around your print. I also recommend removing the tag blank's protective film one side at a time, just before you sublimate. And when sublimating, set the temperature of your easy press to 365 degrees Fahrenheit or 185 degrees Celsius, and set the timer for 55 seconds when pressing. And make sure you let the tag cool completely before removing the film and sublimating the second side. You did it! You now have a beautiful, professional-looking luggage tag with a QR code. The link is permanently embedded in the material, so it won't peel, crack, or fade with use. Attach your tag to your luggage using the included strap, and now you have peace of mind for your next trip. I just love knowing my bag has a much better chance of finding its way home if it gets lost now. If you have any questions about designing or sublimating your project, I have a Facebook group just for sublimation crafting. It's a great way to see all of the fun and amazing things you can make. Come join us at jennifermaker.com/sublimation-group. And don't forget to take a photo of your finished luggage tag and share it with me on Facebook. I'd love to see your design. And that's it for today. Until next time, this is Jennifer Maker reminding you to craft a life you love.